Hello there, I would like to buy the house.
Excuse me, sir. You work here?
No, I just hang around here for fun. Joking, I'm joking. How can I help you, friend?
I know this sounds crazy. Some dumb old coot I know is telling me there's these houses you can buy pre-cut.
Not crazy, friend. The very latest in modern convenience. Convenient and cost efficient. Which house do you want? Each one is entirely unique, but also the same.
Excuse me?
Perhaps I'm going too fast, sir. Do you want to buy a house?
I think so.
I'll give you a luxurious, entirely unique pre-cut palace. And if you order today, I guarantee your home in a matter of weeks, maybe sooner.
I'll take that one.
Ah, yes, we have that one in stock.
And I already got credit from the bank.
Oh, fantastic. Now, you write your name here, and you sign your name there, and you will be the proud owner of a factory-built home.
It's that easy.
Pleasure to meet you, Mr. Martin. Albert Cakes, Esquire, at your service.
You boys give me a minute.
What are you doing here? Everything okay?
I'm not sure. Probably. Fella came by the farm. Got attacked on the road. He said the Skinner brothers was hanging around. Lots of them. Left Uncle armed to the teeth back at the ranch.
Who are these two?
Guns for hire. If they're Skinners about, we need them.
We ain't got that kind of money, Charles.
You want to get robbed for your house?
No, but...
Hey, these Skinners can be nasty. Come on. Mr. Devon, you're with me. Mr. Wayne, this is...
Milton. Jim Milton.
Sir, good to meet you.
We're going to be heading up to the Manzanita Post.
Why?
The best smith around is that Norwegian fella up there.
So they say. You boys ready?
Yes, sir, we're ready.
Good, because you're about to get shot at over a goddamn hammer.
You want to build a house with a sniper rifle, then?
I know old Neil's real well. I'll get you a good deal.
Thank you, sir. All right, then. Let's go buy us some tools.
Let's go.
I know the quickest way. Follow me.
Here we go, we're just gonna follow Charles all the way there.
Say, is your friend a Negro or a Redskin?
I think a bit of both, for what it's worth.
Cash is cash, though it's all the same to me. I saw you getting skittish there, but don't you worry, we're not getting shot at.
Oh yeah, I know Charles Smith. If he's got cause to be concerned, it's usually good cause.
You got a shotgun messenger sitting right beside you, all right? Now, suppose you don't know much about robbing caravans.
Not much, I guess. No.
Well, nor do I. But I know a thing or two about protecting them. And if a robber sees some strong men sitting up front, two of them guns for hire, then they're gonna wait for the next set of fools to come on through.
Unless they take the guns to mean they're carrying something valuable. Instead of pre-cut timber and some tools.
What? No. Wait, look, trust me on this. You are overthinking it. You hire a gun, you hire peace of mind and a deterrent. So I'll sit here looking big and scary, and you can concentrate on the horses.
All right. I'll do just that.
Maybe I've done this kind of thing before. And maybe I can handle a weapon. But I'm not so different from you, partner.
Hey! We're taking the next right up towards Manzanita Post.
What were you saying again?
I think you might be.
People wonder how you can handle it, living by your gun. But it's the same as any other occupation, really. When I get home, I put my gun on the rack and it stays there. I mean it, it really stays there. I don't even think about it. My mind's on my wife and the little ones. I'm chopping wood, mending the roof, putting the kids to bed. But when I'm out here, I'm watching the tree line. I got my gun at the ready. And I'm trying to make my employer as comfortable as possible.
That's, real good of you.
You're in good hands. I know this country well.
Good. Am I finally gonna meet this tool maker?
Now, Niels, he's an acquired taste, but boy, can he work metal. Norwegian, you see? Viking blood. Fellas up there used to worship a god with a hammer. Guess I figures they'd still be making them. I'm not sure how much English he speaks, but Niels knows tools.
This is the spot, just up ahead.
Okay.
You boys wait here. After you, Mr. Milton.
Okay, let's go. Now, where is he?
An acquired taste. Let me do the talking.
There he is, working away.
Oh, hello there.
Nils. Nils, it's me. Willard Wayne.
Okay.
This is my associate, Jim Milton.
Okay.
He heard you was the best. Best smith around. He needs some tools. He's building a ranch house up at Beecher's Hope.
Beecher's Hope? Okay.
Have you got any made?
Okay.
Like I said, an acquired taste, but a heart of gold, and he's the best. You off someplace, Nils?
Okay.
So Milton is working with Cakes Hardwood and Timber in town. Should I get them to pay you and add it to his bill up there?
Okay.
Come on, let's get moving.
Okay.
All right then, Beecher's Hope. They've been trying to sell that property for some time, haven't they? Took a look at it myself, as it so happened. Seemed like a lot of work. Too much for me, but more power to you. Must have seen something in it I couldn't. World needs men like you, and men like me too.
Oh, they're here.
Everyone find some cover!
For timber? Got him.
All right. You alive?
For now. Mr. Devin, you okay?
Yes.
Is that the last of them?
I think so.
There's more. They got the tools.
They got Why?
The plane.
All right. You stay here. Guard the wagon. Charles, come on.
Let's see what the last one is. Oh, there's more.
These woods are ours. We've come around.
Oh, here he comes. Wayne.
Mr. Wayne! Charles, I found the tools. Now, where's Mr.?
Oh.
Shit. Right.
Ooh. Now, that's gonna hurt.
Jesus. You gotta move fast. Come on.
Let's get out of here.
God damn it. A few minutes ago, he was chewing my ear off.
He knew what he was getting into.
Did he?
Skinner? Everyone knows.
Except me.
Later, John.
You all right carrying him?
I got it. There's no use in you getting blood. Mr. Wayne didn't make it. Here, Lord, no. We have to get out of here. You take him in the back wagon. Come on, help me.
Let me put the tools off.
All right, let's get out of here.
Okay, John, I'm riding with you.
Idiot.
Get us back to Beaches.
Let's get out of here.
Those were the Skinner brothers.
I told you I was worried.
Sadie said something too. What kind of land have I bought?
It's not the land. The Skinners move around. They're here for now.
I thought this kind of bloodshed was meant to be over with. What was all the nonsense about civilization?
This kind of bloodshed is different. Folks have been killed, sure. For good reason and bad. But rarely just for the fun of it.
Oh, wait, we're here now.
Fun for them?
No. Not that time. Most folk don't usually put up with such a fight.
Then I hope we put an end to it.
There was a caravan. A few months back, massacred. Men, women, children. Ended up like Wayne. Or worse.
Uncle! Uncle! Uncle!
I was...
You useless sack of crap.
I was keeping guard.
Really?
Whoa. What happened?
Skinner brothers.
A lot of them?
Enough.
Once this is done, I'll take Mr. Devon back to town and get poor Mr. Wayne buried.
Okay. Be careful.
Well, I will. But I'm fairly sure we scared him off for now.
Bad business. Well, we'll be safe together.
Sure. If you say so.
And John, I love you. Don't you forget that.
Thank you.
Let me go see that uncle, see what he wants. Uncle! Oh, wait, one sec. I need some energy. There we go. Now, uncle.
Make any sense?
Oh, sure. Seems easy enough, I think. How hard can it be? But I'll tell you what I think, just to be safe. I'll do the reading and planning, and you do the building.
How did I know you'd try to weasel out of doing any work?
Oh, now, that is plain unfair. It's inaccurate and not what's going to happen. I'm simply going to use what I've got, which is a brain. Or you use what you've got, which is less of a brain.
Let's get started.
Well, first thing it says the foundation, which involves moving those heavy wooden joists. Definitely not a job for a man with terminal lumbago unless you want to dig a 6-foot-deep hole for me when the work day's over.
Don't tempt me.
Oh, here comes Charles. Maybe he can lighten the mood a little.
How'd you get on?
He'll be back, but not for a while.
Charles, dear boy, John needs help moving these joists. Now, come on. Get a move on. We gotta get started before the rains come.
You're very annoying.
He's right. We should get on with this.
But a lift. Come on, Charles, we can do it. Here we go. Oh, another one. Here we go. Up we go.
Together.
The house is complete.
And I think that's everything.
John Marston, you have a home.
So do you.
Oh, I know.
And you, Charles, as long as you'll stay with us.
Thank you.
Gentlemen, to this happy home. At least till this fool gets his woman back.
My darling Abigail, I hope you and Jack are doing well. I remain a fool, and I'm sure I shall die a fool. But I'm trying very hard to be something like the man you deserve. I have done something very silly in an effort to impress you. And that is, I've purchased a home. The land you read about in the newspaper up at Beecher's Hope is now ours, and we are going to try our hand at ranching. Mr. Geddes kindly helped me buy the land. I met Uncle while I was coming out of the bank, and while I know your feelings about him, he has been enormously helpful in his own fashion. Charles Smith has also appeared and is unsurprisingly a pillar of strength. Together, we've built you a home. I hope soon to show it to you. I miss you and the boy more than I can express. Please, come back to me. Yours always, John.